table, and now let's start our revision with pure aloha. So in pure aloha we can transmit anytime. There is no carrier sensing, and collisions do occur. So what happens when collisions occur? A backoff time is given, that is the time, it is a random time allotted to each channel, to each sender whenever a collision occurs. So it stops trying for that amount of time and then again sends the request to the channel for transferring the frame. Now G is mean number of frames transmitted per frame time, and P is the probability of success, and S is the mean number of success per frame time. So what counts as a success? So in case of pure aloha we are taking infinite population. So we have infinitely many stations which want to transmit a fixed number of frames, and the mean number of such frames is represented by G. So this vulnerable time interval is an important concept. In case of pure aloha, there is no condition as to when a station can transmit its data. So for example, A, B and C want to transmit their data on this channel, and at a time only one of them can transmit their frames. So let's say we want to check the success for B. So at this time B starts transmitting its frame. What if C comes in between? We don't want that. We don't want it for this time interval, let's say T. And if A has already been transmitting at this time interval, we also don't want C to come here and collide with A, as B wants to transmit next and this time interval is T. So we need at least 2 T time free for a frame to be transmitted, as if a collision occurs here and another after some time, let's say after some backoff time, it again starts transmitting, this will collide with our with station B who wants to transmit after some time. So we don't want this. So 2T is the vulnerable time interval in this case. So as it is a infinite channel, Poisson's distribution can very well capture the essence of this problem. So Pn for T is the probability that n stations occur in time T, and this is the Poisson's formula. We know that the mean is G and the vulnerable time interval is 2T. So we need no other station to transmit a frame for 2T time interval. So we put the values of G and 2 in this equation, and for P0 2 we get the value e to the power minus 2G. Then S, that is the mean number of success per frame time, is given as P naught into G, that is e to the power minus 2G into G. So S max is when G equals 1/2. We can calculate this by doing ds by dg and making it equal to 0. So we will find the value of G equals 1/2. So S equals e to the power minus 1 and 1/2, which gives the answer as 0.184, that is 18.4%. Now, moving on to slotted aloha. It is similar to pure aloha, just there is one big difference that the time intervals are divided into slots. So, if A and B want to transmit at a certain time, they have to wait until a new time interval is started. So, A and B do this. If one of A wins, A transmits its frame. Then, if C comes, C cannot just barge in between. C has to wait for the next time interval, which is this, and then start transmitting if it gets a free channel. So here the vulnerable time interval comes out to be 1T. We don't want anything to come in between, only this time slot. So we use the same Poisson distribution formula here and put vulnerable time as 1. So we get S equal to e to the power minus g into g. And we do the same thing by doing ds by dg equal to 0 to calculate the value of S max. That is 36.8%. And for infinite population slotted aloha, we have these two conditions, that if g is less than 1, the system is underloaded, so we get a poor performance, and if g is greater than 1, that means the system is overloaded, and due to that we also get a poor performance. So whenever g is equal to 1, we get the best possible performance, giving S max equal to 36.8%. Now moving on to finite population slotted aloha. Here let us assume that gi for all I is same. So for A, B, C and so on, their mean number of frames they need to transmit per frame time is given as this. And we assume that all of them are equal to gi. And g, that is the total, is summation of gi by n. Summation of gi. As gi are all equal, we get n gi. So the value of gi becomes g by n. Similarly, the value of S is summation of Si, that is n Si. So we get Si equal to S by n. So we know that Si equals to Gi into 1 minus Gi to the power n minus 1. And where did this come from? So we know that for A to be successful, we need everyone else to fail. So this is when A is successful, and this is when n minus 1, like everyone except A, fails. So so this is the formula for mean number of success per frame time. This can be written as this: S by G equals 1 minus g by n into the power minus 1. And if we do this for n tending to infinity, 1 minus x by n to the power n, we get e to the power minus x. This is the formula whenever n tends to infinity. So in finite population, if we convert it into infinite population, we get the same result as we have seen before. So this is the end of Aloha revision series, and hope you